The stock market gained more than 8% last week. This week, the market is already setting new record highs. Let's bring in Joel Hawthorne, founder of the Morning Snapshot, to get his take. Joel, the market is on fire.
Yes, indeed. Angie, thank you for having me as always. I am definitely the voice for optimism. I've been screaming this for quite some time, saying many, many weeks here that this market is resilient. Here we are making all-time highs in the NASDAQ and the S&P 500. This is something that right now, if you would have said this back in March, definitely back any time in February, at the end of February, everyone would have thought we were out of our minds. But look at us here, all-time highs here, right before fall, end of August, making these record highs. Very impressive for this market right now.
Are you going to continue to be bullish? That's the question.
I am. I really am. I think the market has digested some of the very bad news that we've seen about this pandemic, this horrible thing that has kind of really had us looking at the world in a different scope. But my optimism is that the worst days are behind us. We do know as we approach the fall, some are expecting some kind of outbreak, maybe a resurgence. But I think globally, we'll have this thing a little bit more under wraps. So I think we won't have those entire shutdowns again, which I think will also help boost the economy. So I am very bullish overall. Yes, indeed.
Apple instituted its 4-for-1 stock split after the close last night. That new stock, sliced four ways, will begin trading next Monday. What's your trade here?
Still very bullish on Apple. Apple has hit some all-time highs here this week already prior to that stock split. I think a lot of optimism around Apple is coincides with the overall market. Keep in mind that Apple somewhat trades like an index. So when we see the NASDAQs of the world and the S&P 500 of the world, Apple is going to move in relationship with those. That stock split is to make that price more affordable for investors who just don't want, can't afford to pay that $500 a share. If you're, you know, for retail investors, you're looking for somewhat sometimes of a smaller stock price. So that stock split really affords them an opportunity to have a seat at the table, so to speak. So optimism around that. I'm watching a lot of the call activity, though, or option activity, I should say. And as of this week, there's a lot of call activity right around that $500 strike. And that's something that I'm watching very closely. So I'll be on the lookout for that this week, watching closely. But I bullish optimism there overall in Apple. And that stock split should definitely help that.
Thank you, Joel.
Thanks for having me, Angie.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.